2 hours. All male confessions and S supports. All female confessions and S supports.
Professor, I've been waiting for you a while. I've just been out here watching the sky grow lighter. No, it's okay. I just got here way too early. It's really just hitting me. For the past 5 years,
I forgot about the sax music.
But now the war's over. It's time for a new way of life. So, I've decided I want to take responsibility for my own fate.
Oh man, everybody's old hair. This hair's way better.
That's right.
This is Sylvain's best hair.
My crest doesn't decide my fate. I do. It's
at the end
the
of Hopes,
right
we're gonna
direction.
Do like all the hairs.
I don't want to marry a girl who
we're
wants to
do...
use me for my crest, or a girl
who says I'm not gonna use
for
you for your crest, Sylvain.
I want to marry
what's
someone
a pretty
I really
ring.
Care about, and you know maybe I can't, but I'd like to try.
Aww.
You don't believe me? I probably should have seen that coming.
In that case, Sylvain,
I'll
no.
just have to propose to you over and over again until you know I'm serious. Marry me. I'd do anything for you.
Aw, Sylvain.
Especially to myself.
Oh, especially to myself. That's good. If you cheat on me, you'll pay dearly.
If we're together,
he's
I don't
like,
even care
yes.
if I stay locked up inside for the rest of my life. If you told me you didn't want me to look at another woman, I'd go blind for you.
Damn, okay, that's taking it a bit far, Sylvain.
I got a little excited. I've spent my whole life relying on flowery language, so it's a bit hard to rein it in. Okay, calming down now. I'm just over the moon about this.
I like how they,
I'm excited to find out what this new way of life is all about. We fought hard for today. And I'm beyond happy just to be alive. And now, I'm engaged to the perfect woman. Strike that. You know what? My happiness isn't what I care about today. I'm going to spend the rest of our lives together trying to make you happy.
You're allowed to make yourself happy too, Sylvain. Still a little misguided, but I love it. Gilbert!
Changes.
Hey, Dark Goku. There you go,
Even
Prezi.
Even though Lady Rhea has withdrawn from duty, and you have become the new Archbishop, the
oh
monastery.
My God. Gilbert, you're married.
The continent is united under its rightful.
I want to see Aloise's ending because I know he
change,
has one.
This place stays the same.
Man, who actually picked
Gilbert? I
have been
considering what to do for some time, and I have chosen to remain here. Of course, I have obtained His Majesty's blessing in this. He told me I should live as I see fit. I believe
well,
this
I like how they
soldier's
changed,
duty has come
Sylvain.
To an end. It feels lonely, yet
in,
I think it is a good thing. There is one other thing. My youth may be gone, but I would like to
hopes.
Offer you my service as a knight.
They made him, like, very serious. Me. Aw, rest up, Prezi. Thank you so much again for the raid.
The war is over, yet there are still difficulties to face. We of the Church must join hands with the Holy Kingdom of Fargus.
That's good, Gilbert.
To make a better world.
Proud
but
of
I
you.
Hope I can form a... I suppose I can nearly forgot something.
Teach the
important.
Orphans to fish.
Yes. I would like to put an end to the deception that has been my life. Your Grace, I humbly request that you call me by my true name. I am Gustav Eddie Dominic.
Eddie? Counting on you, Eddie.
Yes, my liege.
My liege.
I hereby swear my allegiance to you, unwavering and forevermore. On my honor as a knight, I will
down?
Shield you from all troubles. I swear from
Wait.
This day forth
it's not even
to
the
protect
same
your
person.
Life and your smile.
I was
I finally found
not
it.
Expecting that.
Oh.
it out. I will be your shield. Like, did he turned into a romance novel cover. He did. Oh my god. I was not expecting that. Why? This is Jeremy looking fine.
I finally
fine,
found you. It is a fine night. The stars seem closer than usual. Just like last time.
Oh my god. This is awkward because it's like
I needed to speak with you.
To do with anyone else is like a no TP.
Yes. When I left the capital, I told His Majesty that I would be leaving his service.
This is the worst ending ever. Look at even Bylus, like,
he
what?
My decision with a smile.
But aren't you guys in love? Like,
I do not think I have fully accepted it myself yet, to be honest.
Bylus is like, what?
It was all so that I could give you this. I have come to ask for your hand in marriage.
I like how Sylvain had like a giant rock in it. And Deduz is all like more subtle, and it's like just got a little gem in it. Like, it's like even the ring is like per character.
I adore you. I understand that as the new Archbishop, you cannot take marriage lightly.
This is where in our heads we put Dimitri in place of Byleth, and Byleth doesn't say anything, so like you can just like put Dimitri in there, right? We can put the two. Right, we can edit the two of them, their endings together. Like, he's proposing to Dimitri.
But even in the face of rejection, I cannot leave these words.
Right. This is like flat out of character for him, right? That's what makes it really weird. There you go. Honestly, the only way Byleth marrying Dudu makes sense is if he's doing it to ensure a political alliance for Dimitri's sake. Yes, actually, in that case, it like that's the only way it could be like in character and make sense.
Okay. Mm-hmm. May I have your answer?
Because then he would do it.
You do. You will marry me?
The blush.
I am not good with words.
Aww.
Would you really have me, uninteresting as I am?
I would have you just as you are.
I see. Why are you making that face? Is it so odd to see me laugh? I see. Well then.
His house's hair is the best.
One more request.
Hope's hair is the best.
I know it is sudden. But will you prepare to depart on a journey? I told you once before that I would like to show you the fields of Dusker in bloom.
Aww.
I know that you cannot leave the monastery for long due to your position, but... I am excited also to show you the flowers as they are meant to be seen in my homeland and to be by your side in all the days to come. Yes, it is a fine night indeed.
Looking up at a really bright moon. Cute. Cute.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Yes, Alice!
For someone? Ha ha! You've got a knack for rib ticklers, no bones about it. We weren't planning to meet up. Anyway, things seem to have quieted down across all of Fodland. But we can't slow down now. The work's only just begun. In fact, we'll probably be busier than ever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like his hopes. The little, like,
you do
subtle
look
hopes
quite
beard.
Worn out. But when we've got a little breathing room, I'd like to go fishing with you.
Fishing!
We can sit by the water together and
with
idly Aloe's cast
nice.
Our lines.
Thank you for the giveaway, Red. There's a giveaway world. Open for a Steam game! Exclamation point Waffle and up to 100
peaches. It occurs to me. Were you really waiting for someone? A little rendezvous, perhaps?
Actually, yes.
Oh, so who is it then? Someone I know? It isn't it? Captain Geralt, listen up. I'll ensure that your daughter is matched with none but the worthiest partner.
Oh my god, it started raining outside, like, intensely.
I'm sorry, it's just... when it comes to your life, I get emotional, you know?
Aww.
You've done so well.
Uncle Aloise.
You've persisted through so many obstacles, and you just kept on fighting. I have no doubt Captain Geralt's looking down proudly from heaven right now. And of course, I'm proud of you too. I'm a very proud big brother.
Aww. You're my uncle.
You could have let that one slide. At any rate, let's keep marching forward together. For Fodlan. For the captain.
Yeah.
Of course you can count on me. As long as I live, I'll be your most faithful ally.
Yay, Aloise!
Come now, my friend. You must stop staying up so late. Tomorrow is yet another early morning. Then again, I know that matters little. You cannot sleep, can you?
Man, I patched. Remember, I patched Dimitri.
I, of course. I want you to know I am sorry for making you do so much when your battle wounds aren't even completely
healed. Super ultra emo, dark eye patch, messy hair, Dimitri.
Do not worry about me.
Unkept Dimitri.
I still have some numbness in my hand, but it should not hinder me too much.
I don't like broken Dimitri. I like broken Dimitri until Hope's Dimitri, best Dimitri.
How many years has it been since I was kept awake by hopes for the future? Rather than by nightmares of the past.
Calm down. This person is like
for 9 long
just
years.
Sitting there hitting the button.
A nightmare in which I am constantly tormented by those who have died. They ask me why I have not avenged them. Why I got to live, yet they had to die. No matter how many corpses I piled up for them, in the end, their voices only grew louder. Voices loathing me, calling out to me. Their inescapable death cries ringing in my ears. Clinging to my soul.
Jesus.
Even now, I can always hear them. I am certain I will be hearing them until the day I die. But I will
God.
Not cover my ears. I will go on living, and their voices will serve as a warning. As a king, and as a wretch who claimed countless lives, I will build a kingdom where the people can live in peace. I am sure she would laugh and call such talk foolish. But I wish to change this world in my own way. Well,
she's like, oh yeah. Anyway, you want to marry me?
Things will be busy from now on. Our first order of business is tomorrow's coronation. Once a professor and student, now an archbishop and a king. How very far we have come. That is true. To me, you will always be the one who guided me so kindly. My ally through all. My beloved.
Oh, Dimitri got the dagger to the shoulder. That's
my
right.
My beloved. Listen, there is something I wish to give you before the
court. Wait, that was kind of sudden.
My ally through all.
Oh.
My beloved. Yes. My beloved.
Oh, I was going to say my beloved something and then changed it to just my beloved. I actually really like that. That's cute. That's cute. I'm gonna steal that.
Listen, there is something I wish to give you before the coronation. Give me your hand. Please, I beg of you, say something. If you do not wish to accept it, please, just tell me. If so, I will face the truth and walk away. What is this?
That's not it at all. She's like, I thought you were marrying the Duke.
Yes, I see. Right. In that case, let us exchange.
No, really? Thank you for that, Mad. Mad says, fun fact, in Japanese, Dimitri uses the same language here to describe what Byleth means to him as he does to Dudu in their A House's support. Thank you for that, Mad. Thank you for that. Which is why Byleth was like, I thought you were already engaged.
Now that I hold them within my own, I see how small and fragile they are. These hands that have saved me countless times. Thank you, my beloved. Your kind, warm hands. May they cling to my own forevermore.
Professor, so this is where you have to.
This is really strange, because he's like my son.
You deserve a break. Is there any way I can lighten the load?
This is so wrong. This is so wrong. This is very wrong.
But I'm sure.
What? Did they start it over? Wait, what happened?
Professor, so this is.
Okay.
Is there any way I can lighten the load?
It's right to you. That's fine.
I'm sure there's more I could do. You need all the rest you can get. It's only going to get
this
more.
This feels more wrong than what to do.
Even I'm tired, and I haven't done nearly as much. It's been a long struggle. Yeah. So many people have died, and far too many of them were civilians. But with the state we're in now, it might actually be the survivors who have it the hardest. I want to help them, like Lenato helped me. And now that I'm a knight, I feel like I actually can.
Yay.
Definitely. When I'm by your side, I'm full of hope for the future. And on that note, there's something I've been meaning to give you.
See, he got the little ring.
I want to be with you for the rest of my life. I want to be there.
I'm your mom. We'll always be together, Ash.
Every smile, every hardship. I know.
Putting a net in Byleth's place.
I know I don't have a crest or a prestigious family legacy, and I've done things I'm not proud of. But if you'd be willing to look past all that, I also know we'd be great together. Yes, sorry, I'm struggling for the right words. It's funny, I've rehearsed this so many times.
Aww.
When the moment actually came, it all just ran right out of my head. What I mean to say is, I love you, and I want to marry you.
Aww, cutie.
You have a ring for me too? Am I dreaming? You really feel the same way about me. Sorry, I'm kind of giddy. This doesn't feel real. To go from a life of stealing on the streets to marrying a wonderful person like you. Am I even allowed to be this happy? I'm worried it could all come crashing down at any moment. Even so, as long as we're together, I think I can handle just about anything. I'm looking forward to our future.
They're not even together, it's just
I know I have my shortcomings, but I promise you, I'll do everything I can to make you happy.
Aw, precious baby boy.
Finally, you came.
Oh my god, is Felix gonna
Wars
have an emotion?
End, but this place never changes.
Epic Sax guy! What's up, Epic Sax guy? You came at
and
the perfect time.
You don't change either.
Epic Sax music is playing.
That's true. We fought to bring peace to Foglin, but peace is so boring. No more chances to swing my sword at enemies, no more life-threatening battles. I know that these are positive developments, but I'm still a warrior at heart.
Here
I am, watching sadly as my blade grows dull.
It's been a day, Felix.
You're right. Damn, I can be a fool sometimes. And on that note, I'll tell you why I asked you to come here. Take this.
Here, take it.
Without a worthy opponent like you at my side, not only will my sword grow dull, it'll rust. So I had to think of a way to make sure you'd always be with me. This is what I came up with. And...
That's so Felix. And...
You're pretty slow on the uptake. Don't you know what this ring means?
I want you to say it. Yeah.
If you keep messing around, I'll... Fine. Listen carefully. I'm not going to say this more than once. I want you to be my wife. Please say yes. Let's get married and stay together until we die. I love you.
That's very... A very Felix way of doing that. That's
all.
He turns his back.
What? You have something to complain about?
Violet's like terrified face.
In that case, I'd better start planning for the future. My future with you.
Oh my god. Perfect. That's so perfect.
No, that's a good touch, Wing.
It's very, very anime. Me and who, Talus? Yes, you and Felix. Oh my god, that's hilarious. Sweet disaster, hello. Cherishi. Hi, Cheru. Oh my god, too fun. That was so Felix. That's hilarious. It's so shoujo, right? Wall slammed by the bad boy and everything. Perfect. There really just is something for everyone. I love it. It's so funny. They did that so well for his character. Cheru says, so funny thing, there's an Australian show called Bluey that has an animator who loves Three Houses. In the hardware store episode, there are crates labeled Edelgard, Claude, Dimitri, and the Claude crate is upside down, and Dimitri is spelled Dimitri because he's missing an I. No, really? Oh my god, that's so funny. I love stuff like that. Pilot, what's my strategy? Oh my god, the Felix ending was perfect. Perfect.
You must be exhausted.
Zenith?
It seems like our work has only increased since the war's end, doesn't it? I am afraid that will not do, Your Majesty. We are in the process of forging a new age. All of Fodlan, noble and commoner alike, is watching your every move. You cannot abandon your post now. The people would feel betrayed. Rhea imparted this role to you, and you are the only one who can fulfill it and accomplish all that must be done. Do you think anyone will permit you to shrink from this noble duty? I am sworn to help you as best I can. That sometimes requires brutal honesty. Believe me, I am just as overburdened as you. But I will not abandon this. Where you go, I follow.
Promise?
Yes. For whatever centuries may yet be ours, I will always remain by your side.
For whatever centuries may yet be ours, I love it, Seth.
I hope you will accept this. I will just come out with it. I love you. Deeply. Will you marry me?
Aw, Seth. I wasn't sure if they were going to go with the, like, Alois and Gilbert ending.
Since
like,
I've
I'm just, I'll be your by your
yours,
side. Or if
I
they were actually going
to
go with, like, the marriage
it would
ending.
Be to exchange wedding vows with you. But there is one thing I want to make sure you understand beyond any doubt. I am not proposing to you out of a sense of duty, nor a desire to perpetuate our bloodline. I want this because
oh,
I am
that.
In love with you.
Thanks for that,
I
Seta.
Cannot conceive of a world without you in it. If you feel the same, will you do me the honor of joining your life with mine?
Aww. Seneth, his is very poetic.
Then allow me to renew my pledge. From this day forward, I will always be at your side. Through good or
he's
ill
so
fortune.
Tall.
Through the greatest of joys and the worst of woes. No matter
Damn.
How daunting the task, I will be there.
Is this our actual wedding, Sedith? Or just like, damn.
However, we must always remember our duty to the people.
Oh, however. At the expense of our
happiness. We should wait to announce our marriage until Fodlan's stability is restored. And with the thought of that day in mind, we must now return to our work.
He did, he wrote this out.
There are people waiting outside your office.
He's had like centuries and lifetimes.
Courage, my love. Let us go forth and face the world together.
As long as Flayne approves. Oh my gosh, too funny. Too funny. Marriage tier ranking. Nothing wrong with being single, Ren. Nothing wrong with it. Stepmommy Violet. This one's weird too, cause like Cyril's like,
oh, hey
our
there.
Our son too.
Just
is he just gonna reject us and say you're not Lady Rhea, so or maybe you're the closest thing I'll ever get to Lady Rhea?
I don't know what to do now anyway. With Lady Rhea gone, I feel like Lady there's Rhea not gone. Much point in me being here anymore. I don't know. Up till now, she's all I've been living for. That's the way it's always been. So I don't have any good ideas about what I ought to do next. I've got nowhere else to go. Not even back to Almira. What am I supposed to do here? Can't stay when there's nothing for me to do. Desire? Huh. I don't know. Only thing I ever really wanted was to serve Lady Rhea. I guess that's what I want. Someone I can help. I don't think I can live my life just for me. Do you think maybe from now on, I mean, if you'd be okay with it, I could
spare the poor boy
a ring? Okay, it's a real snug fit. But why are you giving me this?
Haha, I've trapped you.
Is this a cursed ring? If I run away, I'll die? Why would you... Oh, so I can't leave this place. You really want me to stay that badly? You know what? I'm happy to stay. I'll work real hard and be super useful to you. I think it's kind of who I am, living like this. Being real useful to other folks. Besides, I'll die if I try to leave, right?
Yes!
Actually, this ring could come off pretty easy.
What is this, like, reverse psychology we're using on Cyril right now?
It gives me a reason to stay. That's the whole point, right? Whether we stay or go, I'm sticking with you. I've gone and fallen in love, you know? To be honest, since the first day you showed up, I always did like you. I think I can get a good night's sleep now, knowing I'll still be here tomorrow. I'm gonna head to bed. Sleep tight. Love ya. See ya in the morning.
Okay, so now he's officially our son? That was odd. That was very, very odd.
Oh,
Raphael.
Professor, are you sure it's okay for you to be here?
I think I've seen this one. You're probably time right. Ago.
Even you need a break every
that
once in a while.
That was very strange. Thanks, over. I hate
They're
it.
Still putting you to work, huh?
That was really weird.
I bet you
weird.
It's gonna get pretty busy from here on out.
See, I want to be like Raphael's brother. I don't want to marry him.
Fodlan sure has
His
changed
brothers.
A lot since
I want
you
him
are
to be my brother.
Some places lost their leaders, and other ones got wrecked from all the fighting. You got to decide what to do about the church now, too, huh? Even I understand that much. I'd never become a great knight if I didn't. You bet I do. That's what I've been working toward all this time.
I want to see the
I'm not sure
endings.
You heard, but apparently the battles I fought in made me famous.
Famous?
Folks started calling me the Beast of Leicester.
Yeah.
Can you believe that? People calling me a beast. I was offended at first, but my little sis said it made me sound tough. She must be right, because I've had people asking me to work for him nonstop.
Nice.
I've made my decision, though. I know whose knight I want to be.
Aww.
Speaking of, I got this for you.
He got the little ring.
Will you accept it?
And they all got stones that match by the size.
Marry me, and let me be your knight. Please.
That's way different than
Remember
letting me be your
I
knight.
Told you how important you are to me? Well, I want to be with you and stay by your side. I thought maybe if we got married, then we could always be together. It's awfully nice of you to worry about her, but she'll be fine. I barely took my eye off her, and she grew up into an adult. It won't be easy, but I want her to do whatever's going to make her happy. I'll still keep an eye on her, but she'll be off on her own soon. I guess what I'm saying is, don't worry about her. She'll be okay. I'm more worried about you. You gotta rebuild this world from scratch. That's a whole lot of weight for one person to carry. Enough to crush you. So, will you let me help you? It's a heavy load, but I want to carry it with you. What do you say? Will you let me be your knight?
I will. I love you, Raphael.
Love me? Yes! Yes, yes, yes! From now on and for the rest
he
of forever,
picks her up.
This beast is gonna stay by your side. But wait, I can't just be a physically strong beast. I gotta have a strong mind, too.
Violet looks so cute there.
Whatever you need, I'll work as hard as I can. As hard as anyone. I'll keep training to make sure you can count on me. And I'll love you forever and ever. And ever.
That's so cute. Aww. Can't decide who embodies Himbo more, Raphael, Holst, or Balthus. I would say top Himbo in this game would be Raphael. Yeah. Yeah. And of course, here's my husband.
Came. I wasn't sure
this
you'd find the
ending I
time.
Actually got with female Viola. Don't judge
me. You often
me.
Asked me to meet with you, but this is the first time it has been the other way around. I know I gave you something of a headache. Please forgive my youthful impropriety. Now that the war is finally over, it seems I am able to resume my search for a suitable wife.
Suitable.
Just one. Pedigree and status are no longer priorities for me. I now know that what matters most is the worth of an individual's
soul. He grew a lot. He had a lot of character
there's
development.
There's only one person who calls to my heart. One whose incredible qualities outshine all others. That
oh, damn! He got the big... Oh, damn! He got a bigger, flashier ring than Dimitri! I forgot about that! Damn! Just all lined up in a row, seeing the rings. The rings are so telling. It's so hilarious. He's literally got a bigger ring than the king. Dimitri's wasn't it? Wasn't Dimitri's the same one as like Sylvain? And like it was like with the big like. Of course, Lawrence would be like gold and flashy with multiple gems, multifaceted. Oh my gosh. Lawrence, please. Yeah, House Gloucester richer than the Kingdom of Fargus. Lawrence with the boulder. He would be the flashy one. I'm excited to see if anybody else... Ferdinand's probably got a big flashy one, too. House Gloucester got the money. Oh, my God. Making a necklace. That's a choker right there. Lawrence, please. Oh, jeez. It's about time.
You expected this all along? Am I that predictable?
Oh my god.
I hope to surprise you. I cannot believe I've made such a terrible blunder.
Oh my god.
Even so, surely you have some reply beyond that.
Is it the purple hair? Mad says
no,
it's the purple hair. Is that why you picked Lawrence?
I've gone and made you flustered.
No, I'm not gonna lie. It's
rude.
Ben Diskin.
Please don't fret about it. I'm no longer the type of person to get upset over others.
No, I legit really did love his character development,
remember
though.
Remember when I said you were charismatic? By that time, I had already become unable to imagine anyone but you as my partner. But I did not feel I was your equal. Since then, I have worked tirelessly to improve, to become a man truly worthy of you. What do you think? Have I finally managed it?
Now, what was funny is I... you can lift weights with that ring.
I was.
You know what was funny? Was I actually... We played this on stream, and I...
Please hear my humble
got
proposal.
This ending the day before I went to a local convention and met Ben Diskin.
All time.
And got his autograph. Unfortunately, he didn't have the Lawrence print at the time. He had Caspar, so I got the Caspar print.
You do?
And he has a Lawrence print now. That would have been perfect.
Yes,
that would have been beyond
perfect.
Of course
this should happen. Not even if you scoured all Fodlan could you find a partner more worthy of you. Or my name isn't Lawrence Hellman Gloucester. In any case, I swear to do my utmost to make you happy, and together we will make this world a better place.
See, he wants to make the world a better place. He wants to protect the commoners, the regular people.
So far,
Hanneman! Hanneman! Are we gonna have a love confession with Hanneman, or is it gonna be like, I want you to be by my side. I want you to be my professor forever. I didn't even think about an ending with Hanneman. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Lawrence with the Maximilian Pegasus outfit, yes. The Draw Me as One of Your French Girls print. And it's like holographic and glittery. It's perfect. Why didn't I marry Caspar? Because wasn't just Ben Diskin. No, fair. No. Caspar's a little eccentric. He's a tiny. Caspar's his son. Caspar is kind of a son. He's a teeny himbo. Oh, we were also male Byleth. Yeah, true. Will you be my test subject? Oh my god, he just wants me for my crest.
On our time of war. Though I suppose one can never say all is over and done. You have much still to do, and I have miles to go before I achieve my own dreams. We both have many hardships in store for us, don't you think?
Yes.
Indeed. Well, that talk aside,
what was that little laugh? What? Listen to this. What is this?
Indeed.
Did he just go like creepy old man on me? What was that? Yeah, Caspar is too much of a son. He's too spastic. Another game giveaway. Thank you so much, Ultimate Crystal Peach. Cuz eggs. A raffle is open for a Steam game of your choice from our vault. All you have to do is be following the channel and you can enter to win a game. And you enter by typing !waffle and up to 100 peaches.
Well, that talk aside, I have a bit of a proposition.
I
believe it is better to travel the path through life with someone else rather than go forward alone. And you are indispensable to my research. No, that's not the full truth.
If Hanneman pulls out, like, the big gold ring. Go indispensable?
Yes, you are indispensable to my research, but also to my life. Altogether, aww. I mean.
No, I think it's going to be the middle one.
I have any idea how to treat a woman properly. And so I long thought I would spend my life...
I haven't any idea how to treat a woman properly. What? As not a test subject.
And I want to share everything.
Man, he's being really honest. Yeah, I knew he was going
to
have that one.
To feel the same way, or... Well, that is to say... Would you accept this ring?
Hanuman. I've been waiting.
Did I make you wait? Now, there is an unexpected development.
My goodness. What? I mean...
Well, since the feelings are mutual...
Did anybody have any actually marry Hanuman?
No need to hold ourselves back any longer. Don't you agree? If so...
The, like, romance... The romance cover pic is gonna be, like, him with... Him with long hair like Gilbert, like that popped collar. He's like hiding a little ponytail. Oh my god! Hi, Render.
I say we begin the next phase of our research.
Tie undone, shirt unbuttoned. Takes the monocle off.
No, there's no need to be ready. I'm not planning any tests.
Tests?
I don't want the power of your crest. I want you. Oh. First things first, I'd like to do a thorough study. And in return, perhaps you would care to learn all there is to know about me.
I'm not interested in your crest, but I would like to do a thorough study. Wow, Hanuman, moving a little fast there. I mean... Jeez, okay, wow.
I've never been the subject of someone else's research before, but I am open to the prospect.
Oh, damn.
I can think of no one more suitable for the task
than
the woman I love.
Oh my god.
The future. I mean our future. It offers quite a lot to look forward to. I can't wait to see the results of this new undertaking.
Oh my god. He wants us to study each other. No! Iggy's our son.
The painting I gave you. It was meant for you and you alone. You weren't supposed to show it to anyone, but you hung it in the reception hall.
It's beautiful.
Because of all that you've done. Now everyone knows. Including my father.
Did he paint me
He's
like one of
so
his French girls?
That he and my brother want to see it. He even told me that I should be an artist. That I'm more likely to succeed as an artist than a knight.
Oh my god, Iggy!
Yes. I've dreamed of being an artist for so long, I stopped believing it would actually happen. You know, for that painting, I thought of the most beautiful thing in the world.
Christian Lamont said he cried voicing this cutscene. Aww.
Well, yes. It was a portrait of Sothis, the goddess who descended from heaven to guide humanity. But when I was painting her, I couldn't stop thinking of you. You are the most beautiful thing in the world. And beyond that...
Aww.
Okay. Here goes nothing. I want you to please accept this. Please.
It's gonna be the little ring. Yeah.
Accept? I can't measure up to you. You're the hero of Fodlan, and I'm just a painter. But I can't lie to myself any longer. I can't live my whole life denying myself what makes me the happiest. You taught me that. Taught me to see myself. You taught me everything. You've always been so patient and attentive. You never made me feel small or denied my feelings. You soothed my troubled soul. You are my goddess. I want to be with you for the rest of my life, to love you for all eternity. I want to paint your beauty in portrait after portrait. I want to stay by your side.
Okay, Iggy, my god, yes, 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 Jesus.
What? Did you say what I think you said? You're accepting me as your partner? I asked you because I didn't want to live with the regret of not asking.
Aww.
I decided to be honest, expecting you to spurn me, and yet you said yes. You said yes. You said...
Get a hold of yourself. Let him have this moment, Violet.
Sorry. I almost fainted there. You're sure, though?
Oh my god, best
Absolutely
boy.
Positive? Then I promise to do whatever it takes to be a respectable man, worthy of your partnership. With my paintings, I will bring the world happiness. The same happiness that I feel when I look at you, my beloved goddess. Sorry, was that too much?
Yeah, don't call me a goddess.
Maybe I should just leave it at this. I love you with all of my soul.
Iggy! God damn, Iggy! Wow! That was the best one yet. That was the most romantic one yet. Too bad he's like our son. Damn, sign me up, Iggy. Iggy here representing a geek's response to having their crush notice them. That was the best part, was him saying, I didn't want to live with the regret of not asking you. That was powerful. He's like, I didn't expect you to say yes. I didn't expect you to accept, but I didn't want to live not knowing. Not having at least asked. And then for her to actually say yes. Write it down. That's fanfic material right there. Yes. Okay, but you're going to have to call me mommy. Damn, Iggy. Wow, I didn't expect Iggy to be like the best one. Damn.
With all of my soul.
Damn. Iggy. Write it down, Eternal.
It has been a long, hard road. Would you agree?
Not yet.
You cannot humor me even a little. Perhaps we can agree that every long road comes to an end. That is when friends who have walked together must go their separate ways.
Ferdy's gonna bring out the bling. Ferdy better bring out bling, the same
as
Lawrence.
Duke Eyre. Life will go on. It must. I once asked something of you. I asked you to bear witness to my achievements. But even if I achieve nothing, and there is nothing left of me after I am gone, I still want you to see me.
Aww.
I mean,
yeah.
That I want you to be my wife. I need you as much as I need my next breath. More,
damn.
Perhaps.
Damn.
I hope that you need me, too.
No, not more, but... I understand!
You hear noble Ferdinand von Eyre declare his love for you, and all you say is, I understand? This is torture. Please, if you are going to refuse my proposal, simply tell me. I am not sure I understand. You do. Does that mean...
Let's get married.
Really?
We had to mess with him a little.
Oh, my head is ringing with pure joy, like a thousand bells. It is even greater than the joy of victory in battle. It is victory in life itself. Apologies. I got a little carried away there. I am shaking. I cannot control it. It would be no exaggeration to say that my whole life, everything I have done, has led me to this moment. I am overjoyed. Oh dear, I might faint. Give me a minute or two to regain my balance before you say anything too fantastic. Imagine making our way through life side by side. The whole world has taken on a rosy hue.
Oh my god. These are all so true to character.
I cannot stay upright. Please, let me lean on your shoulder. That is better. We are as close as can be. From now on, we will lean on each other. Thank you, my love.
My love. I love my love.
Professor, I've been waiting for you.
Man, this is I haven't seen this. I was originally going into Black Eagles thinking Lynn, but by the end I was just like, it just doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel right.
How much time do you suppose we have spent together? Enough that I believe I can predict how you'll feel about something. The truth is, I want to ask you a once-in-a-lifetime question. Yes. I know that the end of the war hasn't granted you limitless free time.
We did
your
Eritsa.
You must have more time on your hands than you did during the war,
because...
yes? Would you spend that time with me? I want to know more about you. I want to solve the mysteries that surround you. I don't think I'll ever meet anyone more intoxicating than yourself. I want you to be mine, and I want to be yours. Here is proof of my desire. Will you accept it? Oh, thank goodness. I don't know what I would have done with myself had you turned me down. Though,
taking
I feel
a nap?
Like I've come to understand rather a lot about you. So I didn't honestly think you'd reject me. You doubt me? But I was proven correct the very moment you took the ring. You'll see. I will come to understand you even more. Our future together has only just begun. Before I become bored of this business, I wish to learn all there is about your crest and your strength. And perhaps we'll even come up with ways I could help you guide Fodlan. I as a crest scholar and you as a leader of Fodlan. We will take our first steps together into this new world, the two of us working as one. Once things settle down, we can retire to the countryside. A place where the air is fresh, the lakes are full of fish, the sun is warm, and where we may nap deeply.
Yes, lots of naps, Lynn. I should have known this was about naps.
Without naps, life is nothing but work. I value you too much to let you spend your whole life laboring for others. You're the hero of Fodlan.
Lynn's gonna teach us how to take a break.
Besides, naps are the entire point of retirement. It may be some time until we can nap beneath a tree, peaceful sunlight filtering through the branches. But when that day comes, to have you there lying by my side, paradise. And we will have made so.
So fitting. So fitting.
Yes! We did it!
Seen a lot of streamers pick Edelgard or Yuritsa when they do Crimson Flower. I picked Yuritsa the first time around just for the lulz, because I knew I was going to do it again. And I didn't want Edelgard because, I like Edelgard with Hubert.
Yes! We did it!
So, I didn't want her.
Huh? Oh, Professor!
But then I fell in love and happy.
What are you doing here? Don't you have a lot of important stuff to do? Unlike me, who obviously has a little too much free time. As you can see. You can't stay away. What's that supposed to mean? I know I can be a little reckless, but I don't need a babysitter.
Babysitter?
Oh, do you mean that you snuck out here because you wanted to see me? We can go train if you want. The training ground isn't too far, and...
What?
You... What?
Caspar blue screens.
I don't really know what to say. I guess I never thought about marriage. I mean, I never really had a reason to. Now I'm babbling. I always secretly hoped I could spend my life with you, but this is so unexpected. Come on,
You can't just spring something like this on me. Now I'm flustered, and I can't think of the right thing to say. I'm just so happy, and I can't stop grinning. I bet I look like a real fool right now.
Just a little.
I knew it. I do have a silly grin on my face. All right, now that I've pulled myself together, I want to tell you the same thing you told me. I love you, and I want to marry you. Listen, I know I can be reckless, stubborn, and generally difficult to be around at times. But you once said you'd accept me, even with all of my flaws. When you said that, I made a promise to myself. I promised that I'd always protect you. And, well, sometimes you might have to protect me from myself. But I intend to keep my promise. I'm the one who should be thanking you, putting up with me and all. Whew, okay. I gotta let all these emotions out. I know. You should shout with me.
Oh my god.
Ready?
Oh my god.
I love you forever! Oh, come on! You didn't do it!
Alex doesn't talk. That was very
Caspar.
Sorry for
calling you out here like
oh
this.
No, Claude!
I wanted to talk. Just the two of us. First of all, I wanted to say thank you for all your hard work. It seems like our long struggle may finally be coming to an end.
No, totally,
the way
Eternal.
Forward will certainly be rough.
I know, right? Caspar
right
isn't that tall, right?
Like
as romance cover, Caspar.
Easily upset. If we don't create a new ruling system soon, the Empire and Kingdom will descend into chaos. The coronation ceremony is the first step. Only then will Fodlan truly be a single, united land. I'm sorry that I won't be by your side at such an important event, but I'm certain you'll do great.
You won't be there.
I must return to my homeland. As for ruling this new unified land, well, I'll leave that to you.
Biscuit. Good boy.
The Fodlan blood that flows in my veins. I've made use of it as best I could. Now I've got to use my other bloodline to change my homeland for the better. I have royal connections there, too, insignificant as they may be. It's time for me to struggle all over again and see what good I can do. If I don't change things in both Fodlan and the lands beyond, I'll never set eyes on the kind of world I've dreamed of creating. You're the successor Rhea appointed, aren't you? And now you're also the hero who saved
Fodlan. Did Claude
Fodlan
have the little beardy in the
people who
hopes?
Have nothing to cling to but their goddess? They'll rely on you just like they used to rely on Rhea. You'll be a leader all who are struggling to survive in war-torn lands can look up to. And I want a ruler who can lay down a new set of values for the people. Values that don't exclude anyone for being different. I know it's a lot to
welcome
ask.
Welcome back, Fiery. Ooh,
but you're the
good luck
only
with the job interview.
I have something else to ask. Please, I hope you'll accept this. When I first saw you wield the sword of the Creator, I wanted to use your power to my advantage. I wanted to use you to make my dream of a new world come true. But before long, I realized what I really wanted was to see that new world with you by my side.
Karma's a
I
bitch, ain't it,
Claude? You know? I always will. That's why I have to leave.
Wait, he's giving me the ring and then he's leaving?
Coming back. There's no way I'm gonna let
okay.
you go.
Okay, he's gotta go do his
you
thing,
that,
then he's gonna come, he's promising to come back. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, aww.
For everything. I'll be back before you know it. We'll only be apart for a short while. And now, I'm off to cross Fodlan's throat. I love you. With everything I am. And the next time we see each other, it will be at the dawn of a whole new world. A peaceful, happy world.
Well, calm down. Hold on. No, that was the mid ring. No, that's fine if he has to leave. I don't criticize it for that. And it wasn't really a marriage proposal. It was a like I promised to come. A little
And then in the epilogue text, he does come back. Right. They're not, you got your Claude ending, but it didn't take away Claude's, like, dream. Claude's, like, what he set out to do from the beginning, right? Like, he's got this, you know, thing that's very important to him, and he's still going to go do that. And if he just, like, settled down with you, then he would be giving all that up, and that's not what you want for him. It's kind of like how Mercedes, in her ending, she tells you, like, I'll marry you, but know that I'm still going to go be, like, a nun at the church, basically. She's like, I'm still going to be dedicated to the church. That's still going to be, like, a massive part of my life. Like, she, like, warns you. She's like, do you still want to marry me, even though I'm going to be doing that? Like, you don't own me. We're not going to be together all the time. Like, she says that. And I love that, because they don't have the characters sacrifice their dreams, and which is what you would want in an actual partner, is you don't want them to sacrifice their dreams and what they want to do to be with you. You want to work together and you want to support each other, right? So no, that's perfect for Claude. No, absolutely no, like, hate on the fact that, like, he then goes away, because, like you said, he promises to come back, and then in the ending he does, and then you're together, like, after he does his thing, right? And you know, that goes for a lot of the endings, because, you know, if Byleth becomes the archbishop, like, you know, they're gonna have a ton of responsibilities and stuff, and so, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I loved that they were so true to Mercedes in her ending. Yeah. In one of the endings, Claude gives up his dream to cure Lysithia and marry her, although that was life or death for Lysithia. Interesting. Yeah, some of the endings are really bad. Some of the character endings are really bad. But sometimes it ends up bad, right? Like when, like, I got Caspar and Bernadetta's ending, and they're awful for each other. And the ending says, basically, that they're awful for each other, but it was an arranged marriage. And in that ending, that's just how it ended up. Their families ended up arranging their marriage, and it was not good. And sometimes that just happens, right? Not always happily ever after. Or like Claude and Ingrid getting together. Like, they're, you know, they're friends, but, and, you know, apparently they had a bunch of kids. But, like, you know for a fact that that's not Ingrid's ideal ending. Right? If you actually played the game and talked to her, you know that that's not her ideal ending. So, love you, but Daddy gotta move the continent off of feudalism. Right, exactly. No, this is very true to Claude. That's peaceful, good.
Happy world.
That's good. Claude didn't give up who he was.
You've kept me waiting.
This is wrong. Where have you been? This is no.
The war may be over, but matters of government, diplomacy, and justice remain to be dealt with.
This is a do.
There is one problem in particular that must be sorted first.
Problem that must be sorted.
You. Rather, you and me. To think I had rehearsed a long preamble.
We put Edelgard in Violet's place.
It's all vanished from memory as suddenly as the morning dew. To the point, then. I love you. In fact, I wish to.
Oh, I love Hubert. I adore Hubert. Yes, gladly.
Your candid sincerity is overwhelming. You must have known all along that I had feelings for you. I've already spoken to Her Majesty about this. She told me to follow my heart. She seems to prefer that you be with me rather than some dubious individual.
I do like that in both Dudu and Hubert's endings, they mention, Dudu mentions Dimitri and Hubert mentions Edelgard, because it's like, aren't you already kind of, right? But both of them actually, like, yes, I told them, and they gave me their blessing, right? I like that.
So you could say that we have her blessing. Is that a ring? You came here with the same idea. I cannot believe I am saying this. I am truly happy. I am afraid you've outdone me. I've brought no such token. Not much of a suitor, am I? I've never done well with gifts or flattery. Protecting you is easy, but to be a good husband...
It's okay, just brood, Hubert.
Of course such a thing doesn't bother you. I hope I can support you with the same tenacity. Huh? Thank you for doing me this honor. I once thought killing you would be a great challenge, but a real difficulty was declaring my love.
Hubert, no. I can't even with these. Some of these shots are just ridiculous. Oh my god, too good. Hubert. That man, it was an attempt, RJ. It was an attempt at something. Yes, that was the romance. That's the vampire romance novel. That's the self-insert vampire romance novel cover right there was Hubert's shot. Oh my god. Dedue's was way better. But they were, again, they were both true to their characters. Right? Like, Hubert's not gonna go on and on. Right? Oh, so who were the top three supports for the boys? Professor. Like, if I had to choose my top three. Oh, Iggy, though! Iggy! I almost cried, dude. Iggy's was the best. Iggy's was absolutely the best. We should probably look at, like, Balthus and Yuri. No, Iggy won first place. He gets the S prize for, like, best proposal, for sure. I love how true to Felix's character his was. Felix's was really good. I mean, they were all true to their character pretty much. Dimitri's was okay. Ash was just awkward. Felix's was amazing. Yeah, let's see. Seth, I love how like poetic Seth's was, which makes sense for his character. Like, his was coming right out of a romance novel, which is apt for him. So I liked Seth's was done really well. Cyril last place. Cyril's was awful. Yeah. Lauren's is good. Hanneman, Hanneman. Oh man, Hanneman. Hawk! Thank you so much for the 46 months, Hawk. Cyril is the worst. Iggy takes the prize. Even though I wouldn't want to marry Iggy, because Iggy's my son, his was the best. His was the best. Yeah. I liked Claude's I love Claude's ending shot. It was super good. So Iggy Felix and Seth, I think, take my prize for in that order. Take my prize for the top three. Thank you for that. They were the top three male supports. That's of course not including Balthus and Yuri. We'll have to watch the garbage kids later. Who would I marry between Felix and Seth, since Iggy is son? If those were my only options at the end of the game and I had to pick one, Felix, Seth, and Iggy. I think maybe Seth. Yeah, Seth, if those were my only options. Felix, Dimitri, and Iggy's. Dimitri, again, I'm biased against Dimitri, of course. Man, Dimitri is very emo in his ending. He's like, yes, the blood of my enemies will forever be on my hands, and the voices will always haunt me. Do you want to marry me? Like, and of course, I'm biased against a Dimitri Byleth ending. So, yeah, we're going to do the girls, too. I'm gonna take a quick bio break first. I'd marry Felix so Dedue doesn't have competition. Dedue has no competition. Trying to do Dedue is solid. Trying to take Felix off the market. Felix's ending, though, he got the bad boy ending. Hilarious. So good. I'm biased with Dimitri and love both of the stories. I once felt so Iggy in my youth when I wanted to declare my love to my then girlfriend so many years ago while I was studying. Aww, cute. Cute. Yeah, give me a second to take a bio break and then we'll watch the girls. I'll be back. I'm so glad we thought to do this. This is super fun. Peachybot, how are the girls' supports going to go? Peachybot says, it's my goal to see him without... it's my goal to see him without his armor on. No, we already did the boys. We already did the boys, Super Peachybot. How are the girls going to go? How are the girls going to go? For science, hit me. Okay. I mean, we are... That's Hanneman's ending, I guess. Oh my goodness. We're also bundled up now because it got like crazy cold. It was like super warm this morning and now it's really cold. Okay. So now we have... the girls.
There you are. Everybody's been looking for you.
Well, I forgot Annette had the long hair.
I bet it's a whole lot of work too. If I'm being honest, I'm a little bit envious. Oh, but don't you enjoy keeping busy? After each battle, there's always more to do. So every day is exciting in its own way. Though it's true I haven't been able to relax for a while. No matter where I go or what I do. Okay, so I finally realized why it is I feel this way. It's because... I need you.
Wow, Annette.
When I'm with you, I feel like I can be myself.
You're kind of always yourself.
Doing my best or not doing my best. What really affects my happiness is whether I'm with you or not. actually, I've practiced what I'm gonna say to you countless times. But of course, now that it's time to say it, feeling shy. Terribly shy. You what? Oh goodness.
Ring.
You really mean it. Oh, I'm sorry. Why am I crying?
Wait, Byleth said a thing
I'm
back.
So happy.
That wasn't a selection. That's
so
rare.
I'm worried about this. I was thinking about what I'd do if you said no.
Annette! Aww.
You asked me. I didn't even have to ask you.
Aww, Annette.
I'm just so relieved.
Aww.
I love you so very, very much. We'll be together forever and ever. I promise to make you happier than anyone's ever been. My darling.
My darling! Aww, Annette. That art is super cute.
How did you know I was here?
Bernie, this is gonna be really sweet or really annoying.
All that trouble just for me? The truth is, I've been shutting myself away again.
Once she's in her room, we are in her room. Oh my gosh.
A lot of my old fear started to return. I'm afraid to go home.
That's cute.
Afraid to see my parents. I don't know what to do. Please help me. Wait, where are we going? Don't make me go!
Oh, we went to her room to get her! That was really sweet!
What are we doing here? This is it. We're all alone. The perfect time. You're going to kill me, aren't you? Alright, I've made my peace. And for what it's worth, I'm glad it's... Wait, you wouldn't? Of course you wouldn't. I'm not even worth killing, am I?
We'll shank your dad, though, yeah. Along.
I'll go lock myself away now. What did you just say? Is that a ring? Well,
it matches her hair.
What kind of ring is this? When a man gives a woman a ring, it usually only means... Is that what this means? I don't know what to say. I accept. Of course I accept. This means I'll be able to shut myself away in peace again. You can go off doing your hero things and I'll hold down the fort.
That's not happening.
No, come on, please. You just won't let me off the hook, will you? In that case, I have a favor to ask. There's a reason I've been able to cope with going out of the monastery so much. It's because I've been with you. I'll never completely get over my anxiety, or my fear of strangers, or my compulsive need to run and hide. So whenever you tell me to go outside, I want you to come with me. Wherever we go, whatever we do, I want us to be together. Always.
Perfect.
Because when I'm with you, I feel... Wait, did you agree? You mean it? Oh, you're the greatest! I love you so much! We're going to be so happy together!
She like run up and hug us,
you, Professor.
Catherine.
You're busy. You're going to be the new ruler of Fodlan, after all. I'd just like a word.
Yeah, right, Lilia.
As you might imagine, I've been contemplating my future. That's what I'm trying to figure out. I've always seen myself as a servant of Lady Rhea, not of the Church. Now that she's gone, I'm lost. I don't know what to do.
Oh, she's gonna start simping for me.
I suppose I could go back to Fargus and take up the Karen name again. But that's not what I want. I'd rather not be tied down by my family name. It wouldn't feel right, falling back on knighthood simply because it's what I know. It would be different if I had a reason to continue being a knight. Well... If you told me you wanted me to remain a knight, that would be a good enough reason. Or if you said you wanted me to stay by your side forever. Or if you said you wanted to get married, for example.
Wow, Catherine, okay.
Wait, are you being serious? You are.
She set herself up.
But I'm Thunder Catherine. Whose very name frightens little children. Who knows what I might do to you? I'm no good at cooking
not
or
little
sewing
children.
Or anything remotely domestic. Why me? You love me. I'm glad. As for me, I love you too. Deeply. I never expected things to turn out this way. But now that they have... I'm certain I wish to remain a knight and stay by your side. Will you accept? Good. After all, swinging a sword has been the only life I've known. But from now on, the power of Thunderbrand is ours, not just mine. For now and forever, you can't escape me. I hope you're ready.
That one was a little awkward. That one was a little out of character. They've all been so in character. This one was, I'm like, that's not her. That's not her. That's like, let's make Catherine look like a, like, squee little anime girl. That is so not her. Yeah, unless that was the tackle, like they're gonna fight. Right. No, that seems forced. Now, Dorothea, you could marry her as either male or female, Byleth, right?
Is where you've been?
Same with Lynn.
Everyone's looking for you. With the war over, I'd like to think they'd at least give you a few days rest.
This was your first wife.
Don't worry, I won't tell them you're here. It's a rare occasion for me to have you all to myself.
Strange person.
See, there is one person I must confess I'm just a little bit interested in. What? Is that... That's a ring. It would be very embarrassing if I had the wrong idea, so I have to ask. Are you proposing?
Male?
Here? Now?
Male Violet just kind of shoving these rings in girls' faces, like...
I don't know what to say. Are you sure? You want to spend your life with me? Even though I'm not a songstress anymore? And I don't come from a noble family or have any wealth or land to my name? You won the war. You could pick anyone in the world. Why would you?
Aww.
Okay. I mean, yes. Yes, I love you madly and I'd be happy to marry you. But if we're going to be married, I had better think up a cute nickname for you. Don't you think? Oh, I wonder what I should call you now. Darling, my beloved. So many options. I starred in so many operas where I captured the heart of my beloved. But I never dreamed that it would feel this wonderful when it actually happened. A life singing for you in a peaceful world. I imagine that life will be more wonderful than I ever could have hoped. I love you. I could never sing anything as pure as those three little words.
She bowing to me? What? These ending...
Tell me.
No!
What is it you were actually trying to say?
No. Lane, no. No. I'm gonna marry your dad. We're here to tell her that we're gonna marry Seta.
You are sincerely saying that the progenitor god Sothis dwells within you and that you have inherited her power? That is utterly bizarre.
Oh, wow.
If I may be so bold, do you consider yourself male or female? I have only ever heard you referred to as a male. But Sothis is most assuredly female. Am I to believe that you are a male goddess? I am not certain how much sense that makes. I suppose there are circumstances by which such a thing is possible.
Flane asking the real questions. I never said I was a goddess.
Are you not? But if you have inherited her power, then surely the two of you have become one. Ugh, it all makes my head spin. I suppose I will take your word for it. This is a ring. Oh my, it is beautiful. So delicate and feminine. Is this your ring? So then you walk around with a woman's
She's
ring.
She's still trying to figure out if I'm male or female. I love it.
Am I? Oh, wait. Now I recall. I have heard that it is customary to bestow a ring upon the person one wishes to marry. Which would mean...
Seth is going to murder us.
Me? You? Us? You mean to tell me that you have fallen in love with me? I think I might faint. No one has ever... Well, of course they have not. My apologies.
Of course they have not.
I'm quite taken aback. Are you most certain I am the one whom you love? I always knew there was a deep, special bond between us. I never quite imagined that it might develop
Set
into this.
Kicks through that wall back there.
Perhaps I did imagine it. Often. I must ask once more. Are you certain that you are not the goddess Sothis?
She's still on this.
This is all so surreal. I graciously accept your proposal and this beautiful ring. Your heart. heart is as vast as the ocean. I ask that you wrap me in your embrace, for now and for all eternity.
She looks way too young there. At least we got to see a little is that the first one where we've actually seen Mayo Byleth in the ending? The rest of them have all just been like just the girl. Like, just the girl either bowing or looking up at Mayo Byleth. It's kind of been weird. And I don't like how in, like, pretty much all of these, like, they're talking about something completely different and, like, post-war stuff, and Byleth just kind of shoves a ring in their face. Like, it was way more natural with, like, with the guys. I don't know if it was because most of them proposed, although there were a couple where female Byleth proposed, and I'm pretty sure there's some here where the girl actually proposes. I think Happy proposes first. But, like, I feel like Byleth's just shoving rings in their faces rather than kind of, like, I feel like it was more smoothly transitioned into the, hey, marry me, I love you, with the guys. She looks high on something. She's high on love. Sothis is already merged with me. She's not going to pop out. You almost made coffee go up my nose, Lilia. Lilia said they need to change for all eternity to till Sedeth unalives you. Marry me now, right? Oh my god. Byleth Flayn's ending will mention that Sedeth buried a lance in his head the next day.
And for all eternity.
Oh jeez. Alright, Ingrid.
Does something matter? You seem lost in thought. I know you've been very busy lately. It's wise to take breaks and rest, especially with all that is going on in the world. Actually, I wanted to speak with you about
something. Ingrid's gonna propose to us!
I promised myself I would wait until the war was over. Well? Professor, I have feelings for you. Of course, I respect you as a person, and I'll understand if you can't love me back, but still, I had to tell you.
Aww.
Though my focus has ever been on my duty and training, I cannot deny the feelings that have arisen. My dream is to attain knighthood. But now, I have a new dream to hold tight to. That is to be with you. Always.
Aww, see, that's very Ingrid. This was a good one. No, don't shove it in her face. No. Yes, no. No!
Oh, is this? I must say, I'm a little inelegant with such matters. Battle is all I know.
Knighthood greater than boys, yes.
You truly desire to share your life with me. I am so happy. I worried that my feelings would go unrequited. Now that all of that is out in the open, I feel as light as a feather. My love. I swear to stay by your side, always. I swear on the goddess above, and on you, here at my side. You and I together, entering this new age. No matter what the future brings, I will stand by you as your sword, your shield, and your dearest companion.
Aww.
There is nothing that brings me more joy. It truly is all I need in this world. I love you so very much.
She's lost 5 years.
I'm sorry. I'm overcome. This may take some getting used to.
She looks like Usagi there. That final image didn't look like her, but that was a really good one. That one was super true to her character. That one was really good. RJ gonna put the ring on the table with a yes no checkbox and then call her into the room. Like passing a note in class, yes no, with a picture of a ring. I think so. I think Happy gives Male Byleth the ring. Yeah, there are a few. I wonder if Leone does.
Professor? What are you doing here? I was talking to Gerald.
Aww.
The sky feels so close. Like you can almost touch the stars. I thought my voice might reach him. That the war's finally over. And that his kid and his greatest apprentice did an amazing job out there. Maybe I'm overselling the part I played.
You were amazing.
Thanks. But I was nothing compared to you. I feel like an idiot for ever thinking I could surpass you. I have managed to keep my promise, though. So, how would you feel about hiring me again? Can't exactly go and break my word now, can I? The war's over, but the enemy might still be lurking. What if they're waiting until I'm gone to attack you? But... oh, I get it. You're probably pretty tired of me always trailing after you, huh? Love? As in the way a commander loves his soldiers, right?
At least he said that first before pulling out the ring. Ah, there it is.
That kind of love. Can this really be happening? You want to marry me? Of course I will. You are being serious, right? That would be an awful joke. I'm sorry. I should have been more honest. All that stuff about my promise a minute ago, it was mostly just an excuse for wanting to be near you. But I'm not really the romantic type, so I had a hard time coming out and saying it. Are you sure this is what you want, though? I know I'm not exactly conventional.
Aww.
Yes, I'm really wearing this ring then, aren't I?
There's nothing wrong with
but
you,
Leone. But I do still have a promise to keep with Captain Gerald, too. You've got a big job ahead of you, building a whole new Fodlan. I'm going to support you through all of that. Make sure it never gets to be too much. Then that's that. I promise to protect you until death parts us. And I'll be happy for you to do the same for me.
Oh, that one was really good too. Lysithia.
Professor, I...
Ring.
We have. I can feel that the crests are no longer a part of me. That must mean my body will.
Oh, Lysithia.
Thank you, Professor. No matter the outcome, I feel a sense of peace. I have hope, and that hope will carry me through it all. You've done so much, searching for a way to remove my crest, to save me. I can't tell you how much it means to me.
Aww.
I will not claim my title. House Ordelia will end with my father's generation. After this, I'm going to begin preparations for our family's dissolution.
Wow.
This will ensure that the people of our territory will not be troubled. And my parents will be able to live out their lives in peace. A good question. I hadn't considered it. But assuming I have life left in me, would it be all right if I came back here to stay by your side? Without my crests, I'm not sure what all I'd be able to do for you. But you have given me a new life. I want to use my time to support you however I can. I just... Oh, is this... This is... What I said earlier about not caring what the outcome of all this is, I take it back. For the longest time, I didn't think I'd be around to be a part of the future you and everyone were creating. That I had no place in it. But now, I cannot fight it any longer. I do care, and I do not wish to give up on chasing that future. I do not wish to die. I refuse to give up on myself or on our future. And so, I promise to come back to you, no matter what.
Aww.
Once I'm back...
Aww.
Yes, I quite like the sound of that. Together. It is decided. We will be together forever, living long, full lives. Count on it, my love.
Ah, how come the youngest character, like, looks the oldest in the ending? Like, they made all the quote-unquote older characters look younger, but they made her look older. Except Flame. Oh, that was a really good one, too! Marry Manuela!
There must be tons of young girls falling over themselves just to get near a hero like you.
Yes!
Or are you not interested in such attention? What? Not looking for romance, then? So that's why you never gave in, no matter how many times I tried. Listen, I get it. No need to explain anything. It's better this way. It means I wasn't the problem. Wait, am I the problem? I suppose if I
Did
had some charm,
maybe you would
have fallen
for me. Did you imply that we have a problem for not being romantic?
Oh, why does this always happen to me? I'm not surprised. You can probably have your pick. What?
Literal shock.
Have you gotten me confused with someone
with
else?
With someone else!
Look, you don't need to take pity on me, okay?
Oh my god.
Or... That's not it, is it? I can see it in your eyes.
It's like Kawakami, yes.
Nobody's looked at me that way in a long, long time. I sound like a schoolgirl, but this is the moment I've always dreamed of. So of course I'm going to mess it up by not knowing how to answer.
Nice, Skipper.
Just give me a minute to compose myself. Okay. Come on, Manuela. Ooh, that's better. So,
hi, Skipper. Yes.
Answer.
Come on. Jump.
Yes. Yes, I would love to marry you.
Yeah, Manuela, get some.
Mess,
come on.
And I'll be a massive pain to you from now on. In exchange for the trouble, I promise to give you all of my love. So don't let me down, you hear? You know, until this moment, I didn't realize how much my heart longed to call you my own.
Look at Violet's little
smile. I want to love you, and to be loved by you. I want to share my life with you. And you really like that idea? Oh, goodness. Oh, I just giggled. Maybe I'm not as old as I tell myself. Or maybe
oh my God. Giggle
I just
again.
Giggled. Maybe I... Oh, goodness. Oh, I just giggled. Maybe I'm not as old as I tell myself. Or maybe you just make me feel good about myself.
I apologize
myself.
For chasing make after
me,
you.
Well, calm down.
I make me feel good
make
about...
Make me feel good about myself. Aww, that's really sweet. Make her giggle an alert. Yes. Ah, that's cute. Can you marry Manuela as female Byleth? The giggle though.
Oh, myself. Or maybe you just make me feel good about
it. I apologize for chasing after you. I really need to speak with you. but I can come back if now is not a good time. Thank you. You've always been so accepting of me. You've never rejected me for my flaws. You have given me the strength and courage to look forward to my future. But I won't know what to do with myself when the war has ended. When I'm gone, will I keep moving forward or back?
Skipper, it's okay.
Well, my adoptive father wants me to return home. Well, my adoptive father wants me to return home right away. Though he put all that talk of marrying me off to a powerful noble on hold. For now. Apparently, I'm being hailed as a hero back home. Can you imagine that? Me, a hero.
Aww.
And now my family wants me by their side so they can flaunt my new status about town. How silly. Even so, it is nice that my relationship with my adoptive father has improved. It is starting to feel as though I am a true daughter to him at last.
Hey, Hydro.
No. I've been considering what would be the best course for my future, and... Well, here, please.
Yeah, Marianne! I had a feeling she was gonna be the one to propose.
I'm sorry for surprising you with
whipping
this
out the noble ring.
In truth, I've surprised even myself.
Heck yeah, Marianne!
It's unthinkable that someone who spent their entire life avoiding people could offer you a ring. But who I am now? It's all thanks to you. You've shown me a strength I didn't know I could possess. I wanted you to see how far I've come, and how much I've grown. I guess I wanted you to see me show a little bravery. I'm not asking you to marry me here and now. That would be a bit much, perhaps. Maybe we can just think of this as a promise that you will always be in my heart.
Oh my god! Marry me! He comes out and marry me!
What? Really? You would want to marry me? Even with all my flaws?
Aww.
You know, I'm stronger now, but I can grow even more if you stay by my side. I'll do everything in my power to support you, and I hope you will continue to support me as well. I love you so very deeply. Thank you for giving me the world.
Oh, I'm gonna cry. That was so sweet. Aww. Almost got teary-eyed at the end when she said, "Thank you for giving me the world." Aww. That was so sweet. And I know I love Mercy's. She was my first.
As for the short notice, but I'm so glad you could make it. I'm sure you're very busy being the hero of Fodlan and all. Then I'm afraid that what I'm about to ask may come at an inopportune time. Do you mind hearing me out? Ah, great. Here it is. I'm going to Furtia to meet with my adoptive father, and I'd like you to accompany me.
Hi, Shallon.
I feel the need to set things straight with him, in my own way. I've already decided exactly what I'm going to say. I'm choosing to live my life how I want, in pursuit of my own happiness. I need you to accept that.
Yay.
I'm in charge of my own destiny, not you, not anyone else, just me. I've waited so long to say all that.
Yes, Mercy.
That's a very good question. Where do I start? Remember when I teased that I'd fallen for you? The truth is,
karma's
a
bitch.
Wasn't entirely in jest. I fell for you some time ago. In fact, I'd very much like to spend my life with you. Of course, that's only if you'll have me. Oh my goodness!
I love you, let's get married!
Yes, let's! You've no idea what this means to me. This may be the happiest I've ever been. I'm so glad I could finally express my feelings. Now we can live the rest of our lives together. To think, I was able to choose this path of my own volition, and now I get to walk it with you. Should one person be allowed this much happiness? But still, you're only given one life. Are you sure you want to spend it with me? I may be quite demanding at times, as I intend on pursuing my dreams.
That's right.
I want to help those in need, wherever they may be, and I won't give up on that.
I will support you.
I thought that's what you might say. Perhaps that's why I fell for you. It's just the way you are. All right, let's be off. It's no short journey to Ferdiad.
Aw, she's still one of the best
something
endings.
Something to note. You should know that I can be quite scatterbrained and clumsy, but I will do everything in my power to help and support you too, whatever you may need. What a wonderful life we will lead together.
Aww, she's still one of my favorites.
We really had success. We got the victory.
Oh, Petra.
The war is finished now.
Congrats, bees.
But there are still many, many problems for solving. It is past the time I should be returning to Brigid. Yes. My grandfather. I can't be leaving him now. Our relationship with Fodlan will be changing. I am royalty of Brigid. There are duties that I must be fulfilling. But I can't be sitting on the throne. I will be choosing a new leader. And then I will be returning to Fodlan. This is what my heart is wanting.
Wow.
Yes. I am meaning... no? I will try to speak with more precision. If I were staying away from Fodlan, then I could not be having what I am wanting. And that is... I will be telling you now if you are wanting to hear it. I am wanting to stay with you. I have hopes that we can spend all of our lives close to each other. I want us to be supporting each other and live with each other in times of joy and times of sorrow. In all of the times. Is that a possibility?
Aww.
This is a ring of promise. I have understanding. And I am accepting with all of my heart. Rings are for promising weddings. I read all about that custom in a Fodlan book. I have never told my feelings to someone like that before. I had so much nervousness. You have made my heart fly with happiness. I, Petra, give you my promise. Spirits of Earth, please be guiding us home for all of our days. Spirits of Water, please be filling our cups with kindness and good fortune.
She's wow, wind, marriage vows right
please
now.
Please be gifting us freedom and divine protection. Those are the words we are saying in Brigid when we give someone our promise.
So yeah, all that.
There
I love
is
you.
One other thing to be said.
Yes.
My beloved.
She's
you
doing the
are
Vulcan
the most precious
mind,
thing
no.
in the world to me. You enchant and fascinate me, and each day you set my heart aflame. Did I give you a surprise? I have been practicing those words with great diligence. I am so happy. You have my deep gratitude and all of my heart. For now and forever.
Sorry oh my god! That was so good! And I love how equal they are in that. Like, there's so many that's like, teehee, I'm the giggly girl, marry me. And like, but then there's a couple that are like Marianne was like looking right at Byleth. I think she was like holding his hand, but still it's like they looked very like on equal ground. And I don't think Byleth has been in any of them this much. Wow, that was a really good one. Man.
For now and forever.
Sorry for making you wait. Negotiations went long.
Turn me down, Shamir.
Not curious about the contract? They wanted me to stay on as a mercenary, but I said no. I've been considering a different kind of commitment instead. Less of a contract, more of a promise. Good. I thought you might want to follow Fodlan tradition and exchange reins. Right, that's that. Can we be off? What's wrong? Were you expecting more? We've been fighting together for so long. No need for words. I've said enough, right? I can see this is important to you. Fine then. I vow to stay with you through all of life's many hardships. I will stay by your side, and you'll stay by mine. I left Dagda, crossed through Brigid, and came to Fodlan on my own. I chose the life of a mercenary, alone, and free to live wherever and however I pleased. Now I'm choosing to remain here, to live the rest of my life with you. Is that enough? I'm just embarrassed. Look at us. We have no idea what to do with ourselves. But you're right. This is a special day. Now then, are you ready to go? Fine. We can stay. I've already made a fool of myself. No point in trying to avoid it now. So, what else is there to talk about? Oh, right. Remember when I mentioned how much you have in common with my old partner? I don't think that's actually true. I didn't want to admit that I was attracted to you. So, I convinced myself that I was just pining for the past. I was worried that revealing those feelings would ruin our friendship. Anyway, it's your turn to talk. Tell me about your past. You're lucky I love you. Otherwise, I wouldn't let you get
away. What was his answer? There isn't much to tell? Oh.
You're lucky I love you. Otherwise, I wouldn't let you get away with an answer like that.
Awful final picture. Awful final picture. Started out really fast, But I like how it developed very much. She was just like, well, that's it, you know? And that was very Shamir. But then even when he's like, let's talk a little bit more, it was all very relevant, all very, like, fitting to her. So, like, when she was like, I don't know, it was very, like, how did he even know that she was talking about wanting... Oh, she said, like, I want to make a promise, right? And, like... It's like, what? How did you even have any idea that she was talking about you? I guess he just knew. Then, like, the rest of it. So, like, the beginning was really awkward. This last picture is awful. But then everything else in the middle was really, really good. Really, really good. Very fitting for her.
You get away with an answer like that.
Can we go cruising for chicks together, right?
The children of the goddess have been defeated at last. The shape of the world will be forever changed. Right? Humanity is free now. The world is ours once again. Can you believe it? True. There is still much to be done. We can't ignore the possibility that our enemies will resurface one day. In the end, the fate of this world depends on the choices we make. I don't know what the future holds, but... come what may, will you stay by my side? You chose to
protect me. Now that we've slaughtered everyone.
Will you choose me again? What I'm trying to say is, I need you.
Please accept this
gift. You called me El. That's... that means more than I can say.
Aww.
And this ring, it's lovely. Thank you, my dearest friend. I will happily accept it. I must admit, I feared my feelings would be unrequited. So long as I had you by my side, it never mattered how many enemies I amassed. You were all I needed. All this time, I longed to share my feelings with you, and it seems you wished for the same. Now, our wishes have come true. This feeling, it's overwhelming.
This is so Edelgard, it's so like... like taking command as the emperor. It's like, I long to share my feelings with you. Seems you wish the same. Our wishes have come true now. Like, she's just speaking for the both of us.
Our wishes.
She's like, I'm gonna tell you how it is. I'm gonna tell you what you feel.
It's overwhelming.
Promise to always be there for you.
I promise the same. Together we can achieve anything. We will crush those who slither in the dark and restore peace and order to Fodlan. I will then find a suitable successor and hand over the reins of the Empire. When all that is done, it will be just the two of us. I look forward to starting our life together in the light of a glorious new dawn.
I just realized this female, by the way.
Yes, that is all we can do for now.
She said...
we must remain one. It will be just the two of us over the reins to Fodlan. I will then find a suitable successor.
Does she say the same thing about finding a suitable successor if it's male, Byleth?
Hand over the reins of the Empire.
Slow down, Al. I'm already worked up. And that so she's like, she doesn't want to be the Emperor anymore. She wants to find a successor. It's the same. Not like we'll make a successor, right? And then start our life together, away from
all that is done. It will be just the two of us. I look forward to starting our life together in the light of a glorious new dawn.
Let's make it happen.
Yes, that is all we can do for now. We must remain focused on our goals. To think that I may truly call you my partner and equal now. The solitary reign of Edelgard has come to an end.
Not your, from now your on, equal before?
We walk this path together. With time and care, the darkness shrouding this world will be lifted. You and I will become the light that shines over Fodlan, just as you have shined upon my life.
Okay. That was not my favorite, but it was very Edelgard. It is a little, that's a little goof. They made her look too young. They made her look too uwu anime girl there for sure. Yeah. The face does not match like everything she just said. Don't put a knife in her hand, Ray. Fun fact, Edelgard only explicitly has children with Ferdinand. Really? Ferdinand? Wow. There's like four of them left. Who's left? There's what? Wait, no, two? Who's left? What haven't we done? Rhea! Rhea!
You have shined upon my life.
As I yes! soared through the sky, I spoke with my mother.
Oh my god, give me a sec. Yeah, Edelgard surrenders her power. Interesting. Oh, because she wanted no hereditary rule. That's right. That's right. For all of her, yes, Empire, we must take over. She wanted actually to abolish the like bloodlines, right? Edelgard only has children with Ferdinand. That really. Regarding the heir thing, she wants to abolish hereditary monarchy, so she wants to pick her successor instead of it being her kid, who may or may not actually be good at it. Right. Good on her for that. Good on her for that. Think of the church, Rhea. Oh my gosh. Yeah, don't. I want to watch the Ashen Wolves one too.
Tell me, is it wrong for me to be happy that I escaped death?
Isn't Sothis an ending?
Can you still say such things to me, even after witnessing my other form?
Ah, lucky for you, I'm into dragons.
Thank you. Somehow I feel as though your acceptance alone is my salvation. My sweet companion. I am entrusting the future of Fodlan to you. It is the only logical choice, as everyone wishes for you to be the new leader of this land. I am not qualified to continue leading the people. Though my intention was to keep the peace in Fodlan, I still propagated a false history and deceived my faithful followers. I also took advantage of my position as Archbishop to further my own selfish goal of seeing my mother again. If my foolish actions had anything to do with the war, I wonder.
How do you know?
After all I have done, is it truly acceptable for me to go on living my life? You are aware that it is my fault your fate has been so cruel, are you not?
I mean, at least she's taking responsibility.
You have become so strong. You and I, we were brought together by the flow of time and bound by the hands of fate. I took you on as a professor, and ever since, well, I believe with all of my heart that this outcome was meant to be. Oh, perhaps it is disrespectful of me to say that. Because it gives all of the credit to time and to fate, and doesn't pay you due honor for all of the
choices
you made.
She does admit her wrongs here.
That brought us to this moment.
Yeah, no, I gotta give her that much.
For all that you have done, for all the joy that you have brought me, thank you. Ever since the tragedy at the Red Canyon, I have lived a solitary life. In an effort to fill the hole left by that solitude, I took up the challenge of reviving the Progenitor God. I wished for you to become the Progenitor God. I wished desperately to be held in my mother's arms once more. But that has changed.
There's all kinds of anime messed up, Rhea.
I wish only for you to be yourself, and to have you by my side. I love you dearly, and so I must ask, will you accept
like as a mom or like
if
as a
feel the same,
daughter or
like nothing
as
more
a...
than to spend the rest of my life with you.
A lot of mixed signals here, Rhea. Rhea did not bring out the golden bling.
For me,
I absolutely love that Lorenz and Ferdinand were the two that brought out the gaudy giant gold rings.
I never thought I would know a day so blissful as this, that we found each other. Perhaps that means my mother is looking after us, guiding us.
This is very complicated.
As the new leader of Fodlan,
okay, that's a very nice picture,
though. If you wish for this time of peace to be everlasting, well then, I will happily dedicate my life to supporting you.
Yeah, Talos, agreed.
No matter what obstacles
this character development should have been
encounter.
Outside of this support.
I believe that our bond, no, rather our love, I believe that our love can overcome all.
Is it, how is it even more creepy if you imagine her saying all this to male Byleth? Somehow female Byleth is not quite as creepy. Male Byleth, like, somehow seems even creepier.
Together, we can achieve anything. With our love, we will make Fodlan's future as bright as the stars in the sky.
Go on, Rhea. I do like that. That image is
hey,
beautiful.
Professor.
Oh, Hilda! I forgot about Hilda. She's totally gonna propose or just turn us down. Yeah, this should have been what Silver Snow should have been. Yeah, yeah. Stop bringing your mother into this. She's not invited to the wedding. Oh man, no, Hilda, or not Hilda. Rhea. Rhea's scary. No. What if it was Rhea in dragon form? She did say, like, you've seen my true form. Like, are you sure? Hilda who boy? Oh my god.
You're doing daydreaming in a place like this?
Hilda.
I was doing the same thing, but still. I've been thinking, Professor. I worked hard to make it this far. All I wanted was to enjoy life, but so much for that. I had to go and become diligent, and it's entirely your fault. Yes, you believed in me even when I told you not to. When I failed, you encouraged me. You kept looking out for me. Being treated like that, well, it made me want to try harder. I've gone to such lengths for you, you know. What a pain.
I cleaned my room.
Ha! Does that mean I'm off the hook now? I guess it doesn't matter because peace is here. No more hard work. Let's celebrate. Aw, what? I thought the fighting was over. Does this mean what
that
I think
gasp.
It means? Wow, if I accept, we'll be depending on each other for the rest of our lives. Your life's gonna be hard. You wanna lay that burden on me too?
Oh.
Here I thought I was free as a bird again. Don't you think this is a bit much? You're doing it again, overestimating me. And yet, I have no choice but to accept. It's all your fault again. This time, for making me fall in love with you. I do have one condition, however.
I mean, you do have a choice.
Don't go thinking you can keep expecting things from me. A girl's gotta draw a line in the sand somewhere. From now on, I'm only going to do the things I want to do. So, say if I want to support you for the rest of our lives, I'll go ahead and do that. And I'll do the best I can. As for you, you had better keep taking care of me too. Got it?
Okay, but you gotta do your share of the chores.
Well then, now that all of that is settled, I happily accept. Thank you for watching over me and believing in me. Let's keep doing that for each other for the rest of our lives.
Okay. Oh, is this the nobody ending? Wow. Okay. Yeah. What? Okay, Hilda. With like the almost the little cat face, right? She's like, this is why you picked me. Hilda, you're making me work. I would marry Hilda just to be related to Holst. Oh my gosh. Hilda, please. Yeah. You picked me for two good reasons. Stop. Y'all thirsty. Oh my god,
not for
Hilda,
each other,
please.
For the rest of our lives.
Please. War is over. This is the violent solo ending. But this is only the beginning.
Ah,
Sophus!
What is it now? You are a fool! Just
no sax
there,
music
acting
for
nonchalant.
Sophus.
Have you already forgotten about me?
This is after they merged, too. So she is still here.
I also said I would always be with you. But perhaps you would have preferred it if I had vanished without a trace.
So I do need to tell Flame that I'm a boy and a girl.
You were alone. And so I chose to come back to this world to stay with you.
Aww. I was doing okay. I was lonely.
Aww. I know. Keep back your tears.
He's like, I couldn't pick.
And I must say that you have done quite well. Of course you have. I chose to join our souls because I have great faith in you. And yet, I must admit, I did not know you would achieve so much. To think you could have died so early on. Well, who can say? My memory is faint. But all is well that ends so well. Is that not what they say?
Something like that.
Huh? What is that thing?
Is she even here physically?
A ring, of course, but I must ask, for whom?
My pocket!
I see. Or, no, I take it back. You are not making any sense. Could it be that my own feelings were somehow influential? But when I think about it like that, I can't help but feel that I'm so in love, I should make an eternal vow. What? Oh, were you eavesdropping? Oh, fine. I shall admit, I do. I love you deeply, overwhelmingly, passionately. Ours is a love without an end. And so, I guess I shall accept that ring of yours. Indeed, it's only right, for you and I are joined within our souls. And that is much the same as marriage, don't you think? The stone within your chest is little more than decoration now. That means it is within your very soul that I exist.
Oh, I look so sad.
And so? Whatever are you waiting for? Ah, well, just wear it on your own finger. Our love is all that matters, not a ring. The two of us are one, for now and ever. I hope you are aware of that.
I hope you are aware of that.
And come what may, I shall be deep within your heart. I love you. And I can feel the warmth of love from you as well.
You can get this as female Byleth too, right?
I know.
Aw, that's cute.
You can no longer hide a thing from me. The day you die, I'll follow you. We shall journey as one until the I never tire of being around you. Since we could not trade words for far too long, I have much that I wish to say to you.
Okay, interesting.
I know just where to start. Do you recall what we spoke of before? I had told you not to let your guard down. Honestly, I adore you, but you can be so childish.
So she's going to be that scolding partner. Okay, that, ooh.
So that's interesting. That so that's the first I've known that Sothis can come back, right, after merging with him. Because she, like you said you were gone. She's like, oh no, I came back. Okay, so apparently she can come back. So that answers actually some things. We had questions about that in Hopes, right? Not that it's explained, but okay. We saw in Houses that she can come back. Man, that would have been so much better if she wouldn't have gone over enthusiastic with the, I love you deeply, passionately. No, like, it should have been more of a, kind of what it started as, was like, you know, we've been together, our souls have been combined with each other, right? And to say, like, she should have gone the route of, like, I suppose because of that, I have developed feelings, you know, of love for you because our souls are entwined, right? Like that kind of like a literal soulmate, right? And kind of gone along that line. She went with this, like, I love you passionately and I want to kiss you. Oh, too bad I'm not actually here, right? Like, that's, it should have been more like that. Not in Crimson Flower. She can't come back. Even after death, so this will be forever around. You can never get away from her. Wollardbert? Oh yes, top three. Van greater than Byleth, Sothis, yes. Yes. Though I, like I said, except for her going with the, I love you passionately, except for that, I really liked it. That was, if they wouldn't have gone there, it would have been really, like, really nice, like, really perfect. It makes me glad that Atem went to the afterlife instead of being stuck with Yugi forever. If it ended like this, hoo boy, right? There's a good way and a bad way to do it. Oh, Warrior of Light Ardbert. Yes, yes, that we share the same soul, yes. Yeah, I think if Byleth combines with Sothis, yeah, are they immortal? They can be killed, right? But, like, living forever. Okay, so top three female supports. Annette was super cute. Let's see. Ooh, Flayne. I really liked Ingrid's. Ingrid's convinced me and was one of my favorites, even though her character is absolutely best when she ends up with no one. That was by far her best ending, when she did her own thing, because she was always fighting against that arranged marriages and that obligation when that's not what she wants. Like, she always fought against that, and she was always independent. And despite that, this support really convinced me and was really sweet. It was really well done. Leonie's was really good, super true to her character. Even though I don't like I really don't like the thought of, like, Byleth Lysithia getting with Lysithia, I did really like her ending. It was very sweet, with her, like, saying, I'm not going to give up on life, because she thought she was going to die. Manuela's was good. Marianne, super sweet, almost cried at the end. Almost cried. I still love Mercedes. She was my original waifu. It was a fantastic ending for her. Really loved it. Petra's was really good. Holy crap, I don't know if I could pick a top three. Oh, a lot of these were really good. Even Shamir's was good. Except for this was awful. Edelgard's was meh. Rhea. Hildos is all right. Sothis actually might have been a contender if it wasn't for the I love you passionately thing. God, Annette was so sweet. These three right in the middle: Ingrid, Leonie, Marianne. might be my favorite three, because I really think those were most true to their character. Mercy too. Mercy as well. Petra too. Petra's was so good too. Oh man, I love the final Petra's final image. So good. So good. Man, this is not as easy as the guys to pick a top three. I think I might have to do a top five. Bernie, Liza. Bernie's was sweet. Like, I left my room because you made me. I feel strong with you, Byleth. Peachy liked the horse girls and Mercedes, yes. I liked a lot of them. Oh, man. I love that Petra, like, said her little, like, Brigid prayer. That was so good. Hers was so, like, culturally accurate to her character. God, these are so good. So many of these were so good. Oh, man. Like I said, I really like that Ingrid's convinced me, even though Ingrid's best with no man. Hers really convinced me. Oh my gosh. I don't know if I can pick a favorite. Marianne, super, super, super. Oh boy. I think Ingrid, Marianne, and Petra were the best three. As far as an order, man, you want to marry me even with all my flaws? All their end shots are really good too. Okay, no, Ingrid's not. They made Ingrid a little too uwu. Yeah, Marianne and Petra. Marianne and Petra were the top two. This is really hard. Petra and Marianne, yeah. Yeah, those were... Time to bust out the tier list. I have this wish headcanon that if Byleth chooses to stay single, they have an indirect conversation with Geralt, saying what a proud father he is. Oh my god, yes! That would have been perfect. Aww. And it would make sense because he kept the ring. He kept his mom's ring, right, that Geralt gave him. And didn't give it to anybody, right? Didn't pledge himself to anybody. Himself. Pledged himself to himself. And then, having Geralt come back, that would have been perfect. Oh, Yuri! Where's the garbage kids? Ashen Wolves. What is it? S support. We have Ash. Is that all of them? An hour. That's not. Oh, that's all the supports. Well, I guess. Here we go. Balthus's Abs of Fury. Romance, Constance, C to S support. Oh, okay. We can fast forward it. Okay. Look at that! Epic Sax Guy, it's Balthus's Abs. Oh my god. Hilarious. You just bought three houses for the third time. Yes. Yes. Have I seen two of them? I've seen... I married Happy, and then... Something's telling me I've seen Yuri's.
Oh, it's only you. Is there some...
Oh, come now. My sulk ended minutes ago.
Here we go. Oh, Yuritsa!
You're yes. late. Did you intend to keep me waiting for so long?
Yuritsa's ending was good.
Yes, I suppose your position is rather demanding. But you really must get your priorities in order. The moment has come. All these years of research shall finally bear fruit. But first, a request.
Yeah, these are the DLC characters.
You must marry me.
Wait, she had the little ring.
I guess she
her house fell. She's
it
not rich anymore.
It satisfies me to have come up with a way to be with you.
Did she say?
I've given. You must.
You
marry
must
me.
Marry me.
I've given this quite a bit of thought. It satisfies me to have come up with a way to be with you always. For the ruler of the new unified
Constance just taking charge.
To become my personal attendant might seem a step down. However, if we were to be wed, you would have to stay close to me. A perfect plan, wouldn't you agree?
I'm a step in your plan.
I want us to be together for life. That is the definition of marriage.
Oh my god, Constance just ruling this.
For anything less. You came prepared with a ring! Which means we think alike already. We were destined to be together. And it is together that we shall work to restore House Nouvelle. You have no issue with living on House Nouvelle's former land, I trust? Or would it pose difficulties for one in your position to move to the western edge of Fodlin? But that is a detail which can be settled later.
Constance says you will marry me and this is how, yeah.
On what matters.
And this is what we shall do.
Pardon my intrusion, but something alarming.
Gatekeeper! Mary Gatekeeper.
It started around the Goddess Tower, but it's spread throughout the cathedral now. A wave of flowers is... Please, excuse me. I can see you're busy.
This is the best ending, because as gatekeeper.
Ah, I should have realized.
My fiance's magic.
Magic? Your fiance? Since when were you engaged?
His fiance?
Well, congratulations in that case. If that's all this is, then I'll let the others know to stand down.
My dearest...
It's the best, this is the best one. Gatekeeper is heartbroken. Gatekeeper, yes.
What you called me? Oh, I'm all a flutter.
Wait, what? Sorry.
Such charged language. What you called me? Oh, I'm all a flutter. I can't tell whether this is delight or embarrassment. Regardless, I shall consider it to be fair play.
The flowers.
I haven't felt my spirits lifted so since the last time I made a breakthrough in my research.
Poor gatekeeper.
Huh? Oh, do you suppose that piece of spellcraft will suffice to see my house restored? It surely qualifies as a grand achievement, yes? One that shall go down in history. As for what other purpose it might serve, I leave that up to you. You won't object to that, I take it. After all, you can't refuse a request from your darling fiancé.
Oh, Lord. Can we reconsider? Oh my god, that was very fitting. That was very Constance. Depressed, euphoric. Very Constance. Oh, Yuri.
Notebook, what you will. It doesn't matter much to me. Dream alongside me. Get right to it.
Yes, Yuri.
You came?
Yes, Mayo Byleth and Yuri.
I'm sure you already know where this is headed. Seriously? I thought
we have the game version.
Sharper than that. All right, whatever. I'll get right to it. You're the ruler of Fodlan now. That makes you the most powerful person in the world. Next to your brilliance, I'm not much more than a flightless sparrow. All I've got are my dreams, a handful of people working for me, and a pittance of gold. Well, and my undeniable charms, of course. So I've gotta know. Is there any room in your bright and shining world for someone like me?
Aww.
Always straight to the point with you. I should know that by now. Well, here we go then. I want you to take this. Consider it my token of thanks. A repayment for all you've done for me. If that makes you smile.
Aww.
You backed me up when I needed some help, even though I wouldn't admit it. Bit of a turf war, if you recall.
Oh, right, this would be different for Crimson Flower.
It's how I sleep at night. But if you really don't need it, I've got another idea. Maybe it's more of an agreement. In return for this ring, I ask for you.
Aww.
Don't play coy with me. Or maybe you're just dragging me over the coals for fun. I can't recall how many times others have asked me this. Being the one extending the invite? It certainly isn't easy.
He's had a bunch of proposals.
I used to feel like saving the life of even one person who needed it would be enough. But I've set my sights even higher.
Hi, Lara.
A future in which nobody has to die from something as awful as poverty. I know it's a dream worth reaching for, however grand it might be. And you are truly special. I feel like together that dream could be made a reality. It may never happen, but it's important to try. Anyway, I'm just a person like anyone. I'll die, just like anyone. Whenever that happens, someone will have to take over as boss. I've got that all lined up already. And so long as my people keep living with the same tenacity I've taught them, I've no doubt my dream will live on, whether or not I'm around to see to it. My name might fade into the dust, but my dream will remain. For the longest time, that was more than enough. But now I've come to want something else. When I go, I want someone around to write my name in my old notebook. I can't see anyone else more suited to the task than you. What's wrong? Did I say something strange?
Yeah, which is funny. He keeps talking about him dying when set up properly. We now know that he's gonna live long, just like Violet.
I suppose I did just talk a fair bit about death during the proposal, didn't I?
Yes, yes, you did.
Normally, I'm much more charming. I think you get it anyway. So, will you accept my offer? Yeah? Something else you want?
What's your real name?
You certainly don't forget, huh? I've always kept it private out of necessity. Couldn't have such a secret being spread around, after all. If there's anyone I'll tell, it's you. Listen closely now.
Aww. Ah! And then he tells him his name. That's cute. This was a really cute one. This was really cute. With Yuri.
Well, look who it is.
We'll save Happy for last because Happy was my... She was my waifu. So even though I've seen it, we'll watch that again, but we'll save that for last. So we'll do Balthus here. I know, so good.
We considered church turf.
Hey, perfect. You! We need to talk, now.
Oh, Balthus. Let's fight.
You did it for me, didn't you? Without even taking credit for it. Admit it, pal. You ordered the church to protect the people of Kupala. Because of you, those mountains will be considered church turf. And the Eastern Church will be restored.
Okay.
I do. But you know, saving those folks was my gig, not yours. Now that the war's over, I'll just spit it out. I was starting to get excited about fighting that fight. Guess you could say I was disappointed to find you'd beaten me to the punch. But what matters is results, so thank you. There. I said it. Won't say it again. There's still a lot to figure out. The road ahead won't be easy. But this was a giant leap forward. Right.
The DLC is really good. It's worth it.
One more thing I need to get off my chest. I'm a mess. I wasn't planning on doing this just yet, but you forced my hand. I was gonna wait until I had figured out a way to ensure Kupala's safety first. Guess that excuse is out the window. So now, it's time to take the biggest gamble of my life. I'm prepared for the worst.
Biggest gamble of my life.
You, marry me, pal!
Marry me, pal!
Look, I know it's a big ask. I'm beefy, but that aside, I'm not the most eligible bachelor on the block. But I promise to become better. Not so selfish and careless. I want to support you, make you happy. The life I live makes me comfortable, but... comfort be damned! I need you by my side. Always. If I'm not good enough now, just give me time. A year, maybe. 2 years. 5 tops. Okay, you called my bluff. I meant a figurative year. I mean, why not work on myself with you? That makes sense, I swear. You had me going there. But that's a promise, yeah? To have and to hold and so on. I'm not the sort to wait around once I know what I want. Let's get hitched right away. I know a guy.
No, okay.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Guess a lavish party is in order now. We have a lot to do. Speaking of lavish, I know I need to sort out my finances. We'll need a house and all that good stuff. Hey, maybe we can just shack up here at the monastery. What do you think? No need to decide now, my love. Let's just focus on this being happy business. The rest will work itself out. It feels like a lifetime ago. But remember when you told me you'd protect me? At the time, I had no idea how to take it. I wasn't sure I could bear letting someone else look after me. I was sure that in the end, I'd be the one protecting you. That I'd be the strong one. That's how it's always been for me. Guess I was wrong. Suppose so. In the end, we protected each other. To join our strength. To look after you. And be brave enough to let you look after me. That's what marriage is all about, right? Being with you is so natural, it must be fate. But, you know, if fate were a thing. That is. From now on, we'll keep looking out for each other. You can bet on it.
You can bet on it, Balthus! That was sweet. That was sweet. They've all been all the DLC ones are extremely true to their characters. Really good. Happy
is better. This is quite a place. Whatever you wanted to tell me must be pretty important. Okay, what's going on? You're making a weird face.
Where's our saxophone music?
You're going to rule over all of Fodlin, right? Let's talk about that. This is a chance to replace the old hollow Church of Saros with something new. Something better. In your new position, you can make that happen.
Did the channel meet the music? It's the same channel.
Then do it. Those hypocrites preached about love and decency while shoving folks like me into the shadows. That's a pretty shoddy religion in my book. You can reshape it into something that actually helps people. Not that I need any help, mind you. I can help myself just fine. Oh, there's another thing I meant to talk to you about. It's,
No, I put music in.
I know. I'm just nervous, okay? Say whatever you're going to say. I knew you were going to do that. I just knew it. Okay, let me tell you why this is a bad idea. You know that I'll always be coping with this condition, this curse. It'll always be a part of my life. I feel safe with you, but you'll never feel the same with
me.
I'm not the kind of person you should get a cat with. Unless you want your cat to be eaten by monsters. Have you thought about all that? I know you care about me. I care about you too. I wish we could spend our lives together. But it just wouldn't be right. I can't let you throw away your own happiness for my sake. Hold on. You're saying that you imbued this ring with magic? An enchantment that wards off monsters.
This so made you cave and by engage?
My curse? Nice. I'm free?
I totally forgot about this. This was dumb. I don't know why they did this. Maybe so that they could, like, let her do the sigh as, like, a... I don't know, like, that was a good ending or something. Yeah, this is really free. I totally forgot about this. This is just
that
dumb.
Means you weren't really proposing? Oh, and here I am talking about getting a cat together. I just wish a monster would appear just to save me from the embarrassment. Oh, come on. I can't handle all this will we, won't we stuff. My heart's going to pop out of my chest.
This music.
All right. Thank you for giving me a second to collect myself. Yes, you weirdo. Of course I'll marry you.
You weirdo.
Me too. Well, obviously I'm happy, but I'm also... you know what I mean. I appreciate everything you've done for me. You've changed my life in more ways than one. It's hard not to fall for someone like that. Though, of course, I've had a crush on you from the get-go. Oh, forget I said that. I'm all over the place. We don't know what the future has in store for us, but for now, maybe we can forget all that and just enjoy being together. Good. After all, we've worked so hard to get here. Come closer, will you?
Come closer, will you?
Damn, that felt good.
See that? I get that. Like, that's really satisfying to, like, hear her sigh. But, like, I agree with Talis. If they would have built up to it in the other supports, like, if she would have been I don't remember what her other supports are, but, like, if, you know, oh, gosh, like, I wish there was a way, like, you know, and I heard once that there was this ring that, you know, or there was this, maybe this artifact or something that, like, you know, maybe like curse suppressing or monster repelling artifacts are very rare, or I could never afford one, something like that. Maybe not so on the nose, but if they would have kind of like, I agree, put a little bit of that in there leading up, and then if you do the S support, then you actually go through with imbuing the ring with it. Like, that makes sense. They didn't need to do that at all. You could just Byleth could have said the same thing that Balthus said, which I really like Balthus and Happy's A support. He says, well, you don't have to worry about sighing. If you do and a monster shows up, I'll just beat him up, right? And I was like, oh my god, that makes them like perfect for each other, right? And it was a really sweet gesture. Like, he's like, you know, you can just be yourself. You don't have to worry, you don't have to be nervous. You know, like I said, I'll just beat him up, if you know, and you know, I don't know, maybe that's not like feasible or something on the long term or something, but it was super sweet, and it's Balthus, so like, you believe that he could do it, and it's Byleth, so like, you believe that Byleth could beat up a monster if it shows up, right? So like, that would have been so much better, either one of those, than just, oh, I magically imbued it with an anti-monster thing. So That was kind of dumb, but otherwise, Happy's support was really sweet. Creepy outro music. Kaerden, really into Fire Emblem. This is the only Fire Emblem I've played is Three Houses, and now I'm playing through Three Hopes. I just finished my first Three Hopes route today. And I absolutely plan on playing the others. I'm very excited to play the others. I have absolutely fallen in love with all of these characters, with this series. It's just so full and so robust. There's so much to it. And it really does a good job of making you fall in love with the characters. So it's this is the only one I've played, but wow, it makes me want to play more Fire Emblem games for sure. Yeah, I spent the last, like, year and a half going through every single route of Three Houses. And I wanted to do that before playing Three Hopes. So, I'm very glad that I did. There you go. Very glad that I did. We played the Azure Gleam, the Blue Lions route of Hopes. And it was, oh my god, it was so good. It was so good.